You ever wanted to grow your own herbs but never quite managed to get them going? Well, for most of us, a green thumb is just something we were never born with. Thankfully, though, it's not as hard as it seems, and self-confessed herb nerd and Lilydale Free Range Tribe Ambassador Reece Carter joins us this morning with all the tips and tricks for a successful herb garden.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Oh, so nice to have you here. I'm so excited about this because I love growing herbs, but I'm so bad at it.
You know, everyone says that, but I think they think it's going to be scarier than it is. Herbs are generally pretty forgiving, to be honest. And as long as you've got, you know, full sunlight, as long as you've got a nice free-draining soil and regular watering, they tend to be pretty forgiving. They have slightly different needs, and we'll talk about these three in particular. Mm-hmm. But generally speaking, if you do that, you're good to go.
And is there a different rule for when you grow them out in your garden as to maybe on the windowsill?
The only thing you really need to think about when they're in the windowsill or when they're in containers in general is you need to be a lot more diligent with the watering. So you do need to make sure every single day, especially now that we're coming up to our scorching hot summer, you want to keep them nice and wet.
Well, they say there are no bad gardeners, only bad waterers.
Oh, do they?
And I'm a bad waterer.
Okay, we'll fix that. We'll get
And it's really good as well to get outside and to start growing herbs as well, because it's just good for your soul. It's good for your mental health.
Absolutely.
And it's beautiful in food. I mean, it can really change the flavour of things, can't it?
Absolutely. I mean, I think the nutritional benefits of throwing in a little herb into your, you know, your favourite recipes, your favourite summer Lilydale Free Range chicken recipes in particular are obvious. But there's also, you know, such a health benefit just for getting outdoors. And I think that intuitively we know that. It makes sense. But there's actually huge research that shows as little as 20, 30 minutes out in nature, outdoors, can reduce stress, improve mood, and improve concentration. So
fantastic.
Get out there and get your
hands
dirty.
Well, let's get going with some mint to begin with.
Perfect.
That's pretty easy to grow, isn't it, mint? You can go nuts if you let it.
Absolutely. And so we're going to pop it in a pot just because it does tend to go nuts. Mm-hmm. It'll send runners out if you pop it into your garden bed.
Oh, really?
It
becomes a bit of a weed?
Takes over. So keep it in pots. I know I said full sunlight. Mint is one that will get away with just part sunlight. It likes a little bit of shade.
Okay.
So you could plant it in amongst something else?
You
wouldn't want to, then,
you wouldn't
because
want
then it
to.
Goes nuts.
What you can
garden.
Do is you can actually put it in a pot and then submerge that underneath so it doesn't send those runners out.
Okay.
But, I'm not even wearing my gloves. Look at me going rogue.
Oh, chuck it in. And what would you pair some mint with? I mean, that's great for kind of that Thai cooking as well, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely.
You get so many different mints, don't you? You can get ones that are quite hot now. You can get a lot of Asian mints and everything.
Absolutely. I mean, I think it goes beautifully with Vietnamese mint. It goes beautifully with kind of coriander. Like you said, all of those Southeast Asian dishes. Mint's a great one, and it is super, super easy. So we're just going to squeeze. We're going to start with seedlings because we're coming up to summer. Spring's nearly over. It's probably a little bit too late to do seeds.
Okay.
Probably a little bit late for seeds. Mm. So just loosen up your seedling. I'm going to make a total mess.
Gee, that's got a lot of roots. That's good, isn't
it? This is already getting started. So we're just going to kind of massage it a little bit to kind of loosen up the root ball a little bit and pop that in.
Okay.
Now, we've got huge seedlings today
I've
and relatively...
I've got gloves on if you want me
to
help.
Do you want to take over?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Miss Susie, we just need to add a little bit of soil.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yep. So you don't break up the roots, you kind of just softly...
Just softly give it a bit of a massage. Okay. You don't want to damage them. But just, they've been trapped for a while.
Yep.
So free them up a bit.
Yep.
Now, what happens when they go to seed? Like, you've had them in there and then they all go to seed. Do you just leave them in there?
It depends. If they're in the garden bed, you can just leave them go to seed and they'll just keep growing. Generally speaking, I rip mine up and start again.
Oh, okay.
start again. I like to start from scratch.
Yep.
Now, so I said a bit of shade and more water for your mint.
Mm-hmm.
With your parsley, they like their full sun, but again, daily watering for these guys.
Daily watering.
Wow. Set a timer, set a reminder.
See, I'm like you, Sarah. I don't have a green anything in my body whatsoever.
There's something very rewarding, however, about having a luscious garden and something that you put some love and care into and it doesn't die on you.
Absolutely.
I've got to say, though, every time I've tried to grow herbs, it's ended in tears.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Basil just hates life.
Does it?
Yes.
It hates it. Bugs.
Where are you growing
bugs
it?
Bugs love basil.
Oh, I've tried it everywhere. And it's so expensive to keep buying it at the shops. Yeah. You know, you spent like $4 or $5 on it and, you know, it rots in the fridge.
But what a great excuse to get outside anyway. I mean, there's this alarming statistic at the moment. I think it's up to 91% of our days are spent indoors. So any excuse to get outside
and
kind of get your hands dirty. Mm. Fantastic. You
know, I'm lucky. I live in a city of Sydney, and our council lets us have little community herb gardens.
Oh, that's
so
that.
On the corner of my street, there's herbs. And while I don't contribute to looking after it because that'll be dead, I do get out there with the secateurs.
And take it. You well, don't contribute, Suze.
No, only to make it grow more.
Exactly. Oh, of course.
That's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it. Now, what have I done wrong here? Because it's all gone...
Look, it might have been just that the ceiling was a little bit too big for our pot to begin with. So don't take that personally. Right. It will be resilient. Just give it a good watering when you take it home.
And it'll,
it'll be fine.
And it's something we don't have a lot of time of in this segment. Time. It's wonderful, though, cooking with this. It's
absolutely
really, really yummy.
Delicious. Throw that into stuffings with sage, you know, garlic, onion, lemon rind. Beautiful with your chicken dishes. And thyme, unlike the other two, will thrive on neglect. You don't need to water this one nearly as much.
Yeah,
absolutely. So get some thyme in the garden.
So just quickly, when it comes to watering, you say water every day. Do you have to give it a really good drenching every single day or just like a little sip?
Look, if you're doing it in pots like this, I would give it a really solid drenching.
Particularly the terracotta pots, which can dry out quite quickly, yeah?
Absolutely. And so as long as you're using a good quality potting mix that has good drainage and you're using pots that do have a hole in the bottom so it's not going to fill with water, just soak it and allow it to drain. It'll get rid of if you've got too much going on.
And you can actually freeze some herbs too, can't you? You can get a little ice tray and put them all in so you can have them for sort of through the year.
You can dry them. So drying thyme is something I do because in summertime when the sun is at its hottest, that's actually when you get the most volatile oils, which is what gives it its signature flavour and scent. So you honestly just pick them, hang them, tie them together at the base in a brown paper bag and hang them.
Upside down
and just leave them. Leave them until they're nice and dry. And then obviously we use it in a lot of winter dishes. So you pick it in summer when it's nice and flavoursome, leave it to dry, and you know you've got it throughout the year.
Oh, wow.
Reece, you are fantastic. I love that you're a bit of a herb nerd.
Herb nerd.
Wear it with pride. And you can actually get more information on growing your own herb garden and some great tips on cooking by going to www.reececarter.com.au. But as well, everyone in our studio audience, because we love you so much, you're all going home with a special summer gift. You're all getting a Lilydale apron, barbecue tongs, oven mitts, cooler bags, tea towels, and a $20 Coles voucher.
Yay!
You're handsome, you're good with
herbs,
and you come with presents. You're welcome back anytime.